Saithan Valley and Chamlial were twin villages with common trees, crops, birds, and even a common saint, Daleep Singh Manhas. Daleep Singh ji had a large following in the area, and though a Hindu, Muslims far outnumbered Hindus and Sikhs as his disciples. Legend further says that one day, Daleep Singh ji was assaulted and beheaded. His head was buried at Chamlial and body at Saithan Valley village. The twin villages now even had twin shrines, both of their beloved saint. Except over time, Chamlial became a little more important because as Babaji told one of his followers in a dream, the soil shakkar and the water sharbat could cure all and any skin ailment. Chamlial's fame spread and sufferers came from far and near in search of a cure. Nothing changed for 300 years. Every second Thursday in the month of Ashad, both villages celebrated a mela together in memory of their saint. But then, partition came. And the twin villages suddenly had a border in between. Saithan Valley found itself in Pakistan and Chamlial became a part of India. For the followers of Baba Daleep Singh ji, it seemed like their Baba's body had been severed once again from its head. Things worsened with time.
अभी तो बिल्कुल ऐसे बहुत ही दूर हो गए हैं इतने के भी ऐसे भी ज्यादा
Guns and artillery drowned the joyous sounds of drums. From where had come flowers and chadars to pay obeisance came indiscriminate firing, hurting both the shrine and the spirit of Baba Chamlial.
उनकी जो फायरिंग है पाकिस्तान की बहुत जबरदस्त आती थी जब हम खेती करते थे तो वो हमारे ऊपर गोलियों की बछौर कर देते थे
But this year, after a long time, India's peace overtures bore fruit. After great persuasion, the Pakistani Rangers accepted the Indian Border Security Forces invitation to participate in the Mela. On June 24th, the second Thursday in the month of Ashad, once again, the guns fell silent and the drums took over. A group of Pakistani rangers, their families, and a few local representatives from Saithan Valley came with the chadar and flowers as offerings for Baba Chamlial. Tankers containing shakkar soil and sharbat water were sent as prasad from the Indian side. A multitude of humanity on both sides tried hard to catch a glimpse of the other, a neighbor so near, yet so far. Baba Chamlial's Mela was once again a joyous occasion as his disciples on both sides fleetingly forgot differences to celebrate together with reverence and love in peace once again.